Godot Tutorials is not sponsored by or affiliated with the Godot game engine. The series has officially concluded. Thank you so much for joining me. I just want to go over a few things, as always, when a series ends, and that is other resources to learn game programming and game development. I'm going to go over three things. First is the Harvard's game development course. The second are five other YouTube channels where you can learn more about creating Pong in Godot. And lastly, I want to introduce two channels for other Godot-related content. Of course, as always, I want to make sure that you know that Harvard makes free courses on game development, especially their YouTube channel called CS50. Their YouTube channel shows a lot of different aspects of programming in general and, as always, is a great resource, especially for beginners. More specifically, I want to talk about Harvard's CS50's game development track, where you get to learn Pong as the first episode. So please feel free to check that out. They also teach you how to make other games as well, such as Flappy Bird and Mario. Next, I want to go over five different channels. They are Davies Dev, Clear Code, GameDev with Fabs, iaknihs, and Butch Teaches Typing. With Davies Dev, Davies Dev will show you how to create a Pong game in under 7 minutes. What I like about this is that Davies Dev shows you quickly and clearly how to get the basics of a Pong game in Godot through the use of the node system. Next, I want to talk about Clear Code's YouTube channel and their video on creating Pong. It is a 2-hour video which clearly explains step by step on how to get Pong set up in Godot with a playable AI. On top of that, I also enjoy the background music. Game Dev with Fabs is a great video on Pong and setting up with the node system as well, and I like to think of it as the OG of Pong videos in the last 2 years. And they also have a video on Snake in Godot, and it is worth checking out. Next on the list is iaknihs YouTube channel and their video called Ping Pong with Raycast, and as a matter of fact, I believe it is an impressive solution to getting a Pong game working using Raycast. The channel is great because you learn other great ways of getting things working, such as a dialogue system, security cameras, and a snake game using tile maps. Last and not least is Butch Teaches Typing, TDD, and Pong. It is an awesome tutorial that teaches both test-driven development using GUT, or Godot Unit Testing, and Pong all-in-one. Sadly, they do not upload anymore. However, I recommend it as a must to watch if you want to get into test-driven development. Now, lastly, I want to bring up two different YouTube channels. They are KidsCanCode and Game Development Center. They are both YouTube channels. Let's start with KidsCanCode. As a matter of fact, I recommend that you start watching the Godot Recipes series. The Godot Recipe series is great in that it teaches you a bunch of small individual things that, when combined, make the foundation of a game. Speaking of small individual things, now the next channel I want to bring up is Game Development Center and their newest series, Tower Defense. As an avid lover of strategy games myself, I am ecstatic about their newest tutorial on creating your very own tower defense game. The Tower Defense series just started about 2 weeks ago. I binged watched it myself about last week, and I highly recommend you check it out, especially if you are into strategy games. Well, that's all I have for you in this episode. Thank you so much for joining me, and thank you for taking the time to follow me through the journey that was this series. Thank you for subscribing, and thank you for clicking the like button. And I look forward to seeing you in the next series. Have an amazing day.